Hello students, welcome to today's session of science. Students, I hope you all are watching the videos regularly. Before moving to our question, I want to remind you some points. First thing, all subject notes you started getting in PDF. Not only science or maths, all subjects. That all you have to write down in the notebook. Now you have to maintain the separate notebooks for all subjects. Second thing, maths exercises we are doing in videos. All the exercises are doing in videos. And whatever exercises you are getting through video, you should write down in the notebook. Don't wait for PDF notes for maths. Maths we are solving in the videos, that you have to write down in the notebook. Okay, now we will come back to our topic. In the last videos, I explained about the various methods to separate the components of mixer. What are they? You tried to say the processes. Stay explained about hand picking, then threshing, winnowing, sieving, sedimentation, decantation, filtration, and last we learned about evaporation and condensation. These are the various methods by which we can separate the components of mixers. Now we are going to start another topic. What is called a soluble substance? A substance that dissolves in water is called a soluble substance. It may be water or any other liquid. Is called a soluble substance. And most of the substances are dissolved in water. Means water can dissolve many substances. So water is called a universal solvent. Water is called the universal solvent as it can dissolve many substances in it. Now universal solvent, the word is solvent. Along with the solvent, you are going to learn now two, three more words. Solvent, solute, solution. These three terms you have to learn properly. Solvent. What is solvent? The liquid that dissolves a solid. The liquid that dissolves a solid is called a solvent. Water is a solvent. Now, next word is solute, S-O-L-U-T-E, solute. What is called a solute? The solid that dissolves in a liquid is called a solute. The solid that dissolves in a liquid is called a solute. Now, the mixture of solvent and solute is called a solution. So, remember these three terms, solvent, solute, solution. Solvent is the liquid that dissolves a solid substance, and the solid substance that dissolves in a liquid is called a solute, and the mixture of solvent and the solute is called a solution. Here, water can dissolve many substances in it. So water is called a universal solvent. Now, how much of a substance can be dissolved in water? That we will see. For that, activities are given in textbook. You see activity 8, I am explaining now. Take a beaker or any other vessel. Take a glass of water in that beaker. Now you also take some salt. And you try to add 1 spoonful of salt in the beaker. Beaker containing water. Stir it well so that the salt will completely mix with the water and it will get dissolved in water. After dissolving the first spoon of salt, you add 1 more spoon of salt in the same water. That way, you go on adding the salt. And after adding the salt, you have to stir it well. You have to mix it well so that it will get completely mixed and dissolved in the water. After adding some spoons of salt, you can see that some salt will remain in the water undissolved. Even after you are stirring again and again, it will not be mixing with the water. It will remain undissolved. And if you try to taste that water, it will be feeling extremely salty. This is called a saturated solution. This solution of salt is called a saturated solution. So what is saturated solution? The solution that cannot dissolve any more salt. Maximum how much it can dissolve is dissolved. It cannot dissolve any more quantity of salt in it. Such a solution is called a saturated solution. See? It can, no more salt can be dissolved in the water. So then we can say that the solution that cannot dissolve no more salt is called a saturated solution. Okay. Now, is there any way to dissolve some more salt in the saturated solution? That is given in activity 9. See, now you made a saturated solution. Now you will try how to dissolve some more salt in the saturated solution. For that, you have to heat that saturated solution. The vessel in which you made the saturated solution, keep on a stove and heat it. And when you heat the solution, you have to stir it well. And this heating, whatever activity you are doing, which involves heating and warming, you have to be done in presence of any elder solid. That in the last video also I mentioned. And if you heat the saturated solution, you can see that some more salt will be getting dissolved in the solution. That means we can increase the solubility of the water or solubility of the saturated solution by heating it. If we heat the saturated solution, it will increase the solubility and it will dissolve some more salt in it. Okay, so these are the two main points that I explained today. First point, saturated solution. The solution that you cannot dissolve any more salt is called a saturated solution. The second point, we can add some more salt in the saturated solution by heating the saturated solution. Or you can increase the solubility of the saturated solution by heating it. Now today I told water is called a universal solvent. Why? Because it can dissolve many substances in it, like sugar, salt, then many gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide. All these gases can also dissolve in water. Now, but the level of all the substances are not the same. That means water does not dissolve all the substances in the same quantity. Different substances have different levels of solubility in water. Okay, children, this lesson is completed. Now, the next video, I will be revising the lesson one more time. All the important points will be revised one more time. Then very soon you are going to get the notes as PDF and you have to write down all the notes you are getting in the notebook. Okay.